For a long time, there's been a movement in Alaska to preserve and revitalize the indigenous Alaska Native languages. And a lot of folks are solidly behind those kinds of efforts, either in general or as part of their educational system at their school. We invited Rhonda Kite, the CEO of Kiwa Digital, to come and speak at the AASB conference. And she did, but she also came with an idea of why don't we produce a book in 48 hours using students and some advisors, and we'll turn it around, we'll incorporate some languages in there, and it will be a way for intergenerations to work together to produce a product.
They reacted very positively to it, and I think it was a really good cooperative learning experience for them.
We did. We are Alaska on traditional values and how we are as a people and what we do. And my little brothers and sisters like to read that story like every single day. And they press on the words and they copy what they're saying.
I think that's kind of cool, like especially since it's for the kids.
It feels pretty good passing our stories from our elders and from our long time ago ancestors, so that we can be able to pass it on from generation to generation.
So after the first Q-Book Slam, we were able to travel out to Chevak and share the book with the community. It's really cool to see their excitement and to hear them speak Chupik words as we demonstrated the book.
How about sister?
The kids who participated in the slam gained instant credibility and were viewed as rock stars.
This was the first Q-Book Slam in the whole wide world, so that's kind of cool.
We traveled to Chevak that same month. They were interested in doing 12 books, so it was easier to actually take them to New Zealand to the recording studio and within a space of a few days get all of the books recorded and then have them constructed after they left.
When the three speakers, Rebecca Nyaman, Iggy Chiaokun, and Lily Nolson, went to New Zealand, it was a grand adventure. My wife Betsy and I escorted them, as two had never been out of the United States and one didn't have a passport until this trip.
We had to, go to the studios every day from early morning and just spend an entire day talking on the mic or them recording us. Just read through our lines.
We had three technicians working with us. Amazing technicians, really surprising me along the way because they were very fast at picking up on things, These guys were very professional and they knew exactly what we had to do, And without them, this thing would have probably taken a long time. But to my amazement, they were able to, differentiate between the pronunciation of our language.
Nice.
This was a working trip. We would experience Auckland late in the day, but we would get home early for the next day's recording. The three speakers worked all day long in the recording studio for 4 straight days.
So it was quite intense, and at the end of the books, we recorded our vocabulary. Every single word that we said in Chupik, we had to say them one by one, recorded.
The books are constructed in such a way so that even the phonetics of them are easy to follow. So if you're trying to learn a language, this is a great way to do it.
It's pretty amazing how the technology has worked. Especially I'm amazed at how you can pinpoint at the word that and can have it repeated over and over, you know. As long as it takes for you to learn how to say that, and I'm very glad that it's there for our youth.
Traditionally, everything was done by word of mouth and by listening and by observing. You know, we can do all those three using modern technology. It's just today's way of learning.
You know, we're just so proud of the effort that was made to make these books a reality. We now have over 14 books done in Chupik, and the books are being used in the school curriculum, and they're available worldwide for free. More are being developed as we speak. We can't wait to be able to work with others to make this happen in other languages.